What's up? Dr. Swole here, MD bodybuilder, back with another contest prep update on my 2020 prep. So right now we're 23 weeks out, and you know what that means. We've been talking about this for weeks now, diet break and deload. So I'm going to be walking you through exactly how I'm going to be running this week. As an aside, I got asked a question on my other video as to what my waist size is right now. And I just did a little thing on my Instagram story,
right at 28 inches.
It's funny because I actually answered his question before measuring it. I said, I think I'm 28 inches, and I was bang on. So it gives you a sense of how in tune I am in terms of my experience of looking at myself in the mirror and knowing what that translates to in real life changes. A lot of my auto-regulated approach to refeeds and now my diet break and deload depend on the fact that I have very good feedback in terms of what I see in the mirror and on the scale and what that translates to in terms of my fat loss. The last time I measured my waist size was back in around June, and it was 31 inches. So that's very reassuring that I'm losing fat in the right places. Furthermore, it's also doubly important because as a men's physique athlete, I will be judged heavily on how small a waist I have on stage. Now, I'm definitely not the biggest guy, and I probably won't be on show day, but I do know that having a small waist is one of my strengths, and it's definitely going to be something I'll rely on. Right now, the way my deloads are set up, I deload my push movements on every fourth week, and I deload everything altogether every eighth week. My approach to deloading is going to be that I'm going to drop my training volume to maintenance, which is around half. So the way I'm doing that is I'm taking my usual four times a week training program, and I'm dropping that to twice a week. I prefer dropping the number of sessions I have rather than cutting the amount of time per session when I deload, just because it gives me more flexibility in my schedule. I can see my friends, and it gives me a bit of a mental break. In the past, I used to drop my intensity as well as dropping volume. This time, I think I'm gonna try and keep my intensity near my normal levels, just to make sure I'm not losing any muscle. But I will drop a couple of reps on every set, thus dropping my RPE by about 2 points. So I usually train with about one rep in reserve, and this week I'll aim for about three reps in reserve.
One more thing about my deloads is that I like to actually change the exercises up during my deload week. I like to keep my exercises the same for long periods of time in order to see progressive overload. Obviously, there's some component of staleness that develops, and having a week where I switch things up gives me variation and potentially resensitizes my muscles to those movements so that I get a bit of a novel stimulus when I come back to them.
Now, I'm going to be running an auto-regulated diet break this time, which means I'm not actually going to be using a scale to measure my food this week. I'm just going to be using my general habits, so still five meals a day, around 30 grams of protein each, but I'll just be eyeballing my portions and taking some freedom to eat until I feel full and titrate to the scale weight that I see. So from experience, I know that my body usually can store around 2 pounds of glycogen when going from a depleted to a full state. So my lowest weight was 155.8. I'm expecting my weight to go up to around 157.8 this week. I would be worried if it goes more than 3 pounds over, so not more than 158.8 for sure.
To hit 155.8, I know that's the weight I said, and it did get to 155.2, but I'm going to chalk that up to an irregular schedule since this was actually after my refeed started already. As you can see, over the last few weeks, my weight tends to go up by about 2 pounds over the course of the weekend, which is when I refeed, so that's what I expect to see during this week as I diet break and fill up on carbs.
Now, I'm doing this auto-regulated approach in order to give myself a bit of a mental break and some flexibility so I can go out to eat and see my friends. However, it is valuable to continue tracking during a diet break and during refeeds because it gives you valuable information which will be useful when it comes time to peak week. Still, I'm a long ways out from show day, and I've got at least 2 more diet breaks slash deloads coming up, so I'll be more strict closer to the show.
All right, here's my physique update. Just an ab check, first of all. My lower obliques are starting to come in a little bit more, and you could see a little bit more definition between those and my lower abs. I'm pretty full on glycogen right now. lat's still looking around the same as last week. You can see a few striations. And you can also see a bit of tricep striation on this pose. We'll see what happens. I've actually been seeing a little bit of detail coming in my hamstrings with good lighting, which is good to see.
That's all for now, guys. Make sure you like the video, subscribe, and comment below. Let me know what you think about my diet break and deload plan. See you next time.